You're cheating by sex, drugs, rock and roll, stimulants, cocaine, caffeine, drugs of all types, all sorts of depraved behavior and you know, all the kind of stuff that the antidepressants and anxiety medication and all the stuff that they use. That's cheating, is it not? Yeah, so so there can be this competition. I'm not out in the open about it at all, but I feel at some level, you know, I'll be darned if I'm going to be outworked. I never complained that they're working hard. If they want to work hard, fine. I'll just outwork them. Or at least as much. And of course, they're cooperating like crazy here. You know, cooperation's where it's at. They're super cooperative. So I'm being super cooperative with the Holy Spirit. So you, in your spiritual path, you can be super cooperative with the teacher, with the Holy Spirit. Holy Spirit's the ultimate teacher. Various ways of symbolizing grace of God. So you may have a teacher in the flesh here that you can be super cooperative with them, and also work tremendous work ethic and tremendous cooperation ethic. Those two. Don't say we're only going to do one of them. You see, the male-female thing can soften into one unified effort of both cooperation and competition intensely at the same time. And that enables to take the spiritual pill, the wake-up pill. Or many, actually, every day you take another pill, a wake-up pill, as it were, spiritual wake-up pill, formless pill, taking a pill of formlessness, pill of no exceptions, pill of zero, the zero pill. Of course, they go to the teacher and say, "We'll do whatever you say." The cooperative ones will. "We'll just do whatever you say. You're perfect master. Whatever you say." And they said, "Okay, well, let's get into this inquiry here and sit quietly." And they'll say, "I mean anything other than that, but we'll do anything other than that." That's not cooperation, is it? So it's all fake. It's saying, "Oh, you're the perfect teacher." They don't really mean that. They're trying to make a deal. They say, "I'll call you the perfect teacher if you don't have me take this zero pill." No deal. They say, "You're not the perfect teacher. You're a liar. You're a deceiver. You're not the perfect teacher. All those people who say that you are, they're liars, deceivers." Well, not as those who say, "Well, you're the perfect teacher," and they do take the zero pill, they're saying you're the perfect teacher in order to reassure themselves, but they're still getting the work done. They're cooperating. So that's okay. Yeah. Like I said, whatever you want to, however you want to, however you want to think of me, that's fine. Whatever you, like that. As you play the piano, so you hear the tune. I am whatever anyone wants me to be, that sort of thing. Is there, needs to be there. And of course, those who you want to make a deal and know, then they'll get upset. They'll get upset. I am whatever you take me to be is the right attitude of any teacher. I am whatever you take me to be. It's not quite a teacher. It's a reassurer, someone who's good at reassuring. It's a reassurer. I prefer that word than teacher. I don't like the word teacher so much. Because it's the one that comes to them that has the willingness to take the trip, you know. So they're the ones who are, you know, they're bringing a ton of effort to the situation. The reassurer is there to reassure. So, but those who are willing to do this, they're bringing tremendous effort and willingness to do it. So they should be honored. They should be very honored. Jesus insists that he walks beside us, not in front of us and not behind us, but beside us. So the one that walks beside you in reassurance, that's one way to put it. I look at who are those who, the great ones, those are the ones who walk beside us in reassurance. You know, that I prefer that to saying, look, the teacher. Because the teacher implies academia and school and tests and pleasing the teacher and getting an A. And no, the teacher doesn't hand out grades. The one who walks beside us in reassurance that is not handing out candy or grades or anything, or diplomas, they don't have anything to hand out. You have to get it yourself. You have to wake up. There's no diploma that's passed out. So the burn continues, the burn continues. Doesn't show any signs of going away. So, you know, the zero pill is doing its thing. Now, in the spiritual dualism, musicians are also shamans, absolutely. Drugs, it's all part of. And the what do you call it, the love goddesses are also shamans, the tantric love goddesses. So you have I call sex, drugs, rock and roll is what you have in the spiritual dualistic society, which is exactly what we have. We have all these sexperts, you know, the love goddesses or, you know, tantric love goddesses who are these absolute sexperts who take you on a, you know, erotic trip. And you have the drug shamans who are experts at, you know, taking on drug trips. And you have the musicians who are experts on taking on musical trips. And then you also have those who try to combine the whole thing. They think they're the uber shamans, you know, the uber shamans who combine the whole thing. Let's have it all. All the sex, the drugs, and the rock and roll all in one super trip, you know, super trip. That's what you have, isn't it? So the music is again going on this trip that seems to have depth to it. And we've all been there, you know, we've all been there and done that. It's not like I'm talking about something nobody understands. To some degree. I was a super music tripper. Okay, super music tripper. But I can tell you that this spiritual trip, you can't compare it. You can't compare it with the super musical tripping. Cannot. This is totally beyond any musical trip you could ever go on. Totally beyond it. Totally different. Totally different. Totally beyond it. And so this is coming from the horse's mouth. When it comes to music, I was, you know, just a super musical shaman. A super musical shaman. An uber shaman of music. And you know, I realized that's not it. It's not it. And the spiritual path is it. It's way, way more intense. I had to stop my music. I can't play music in this state. That's one thing I can't do. That breaks it. Breaks it. It shatters it. When I say sit quietly, I mean no sex, no drugs, no rock and roll. Right? When you're sitting quietly, those things interrupt it. They throw you off the tracks. You're thrown off the tracks. And no intellectualism. I was also an intellectual shaman. Was not a drug shaman and not a sex shaman. No, intellectual shaman and a musical shaman for sure. Both of those I could, you know, just hold my own with anyone. But those definitely interfere with a spiritual path. So, if for instance I was to bring a guitar in here and start playing, that would really throw things out of whack severely. No question about it. Now there is some music, if you're very careful about it, that can be employed, but it's a slippery slope. Especially if you happen to be a musical shaman, and there are many who have been, I would say leave the music out of it, because it's way too easy to slip back into that. I tried to bring the right music into it. Didn't work. It's better to leave it out. Same with the intellectualism. Leave it out. Many of us have been intellectual shamans, and it's better to leave that out. Certainly leave out the sex, the body work, all that stuff. Leave that out. Certainly leave out all the drugs, all the substances. Leave all that out. But we tend to think, well, the music maybe we can put in there. No, it's very slippery slope. Very slippery slope. I've done it, believe me. I tried to do it, you know, to help out. No. It's not it. It's better to sit with the quiet. Way better. Then you're experiencing the trip. If you want to experience the trip, you got to experience it. When you go into music, you're not experiencing the trip the way it's supposed to be experienced. Same thing with all the tantric sex, the same thing with all the drug use, all those shamans and stuff. No way. That is not the trip. That you're not experiencing the trip when you do any of that. You're not. Absolutely not. It's just sitting quietly. Then you take, that's not the trip. It's taking the pill of zero pill, for instance. Of some dosage. It's all zero pill of some dosage. And you just keep increasing the dosage. But in order to experience the trip, you do need to sit quietly. What kind of trip is it? It's the tripless trip. The tripless trip. That's the intense one. Makes everything else seem like a Cracker Jack prize, you know. Open a box of Cracker Jacks up. There's a prize in there. You get to the prize. What is that? So almost everybody comes to this spiritual path. They're a shaman in some regard, you know, an expert in some regard, and they have to let that go. They have to let go, because this is the tripless trip that they're going on. Different, entirely different, right? Tripless trip. That's where the quiet, the stillness comes in. That's why it's advised, drop your shamanness. Be celibate. Don't take drugs or stimulants. Don't engage in, you know, music and intellectualism and all the stuff, the shamanistic stuff, the spiritual duality. Drop it. Drop it. The fact that you're taking the tripless trip means you transcended all that shamanist, way beyond that. Become way beyond it. Just as soon as you repent, you've gone beyond it. You've gone beyond it. You've gone beyond Einstein, actually. You've gone beyond all the geniuses, of scientific geniuses. You're beyond them already. As soon as you repent, you're actually, because you've started taking the tripless trip, the zero pill, and that's beyond all this stuff, totally. There's all sorts of scientific shamans, right? Einstein's like a scientific shaman. All sorts of those things. That has to be set down too. The scientific shamans need to set that down too. Now, there may be way more than we realize who are actually taking the tripless trip and working on this. They just, nobody knows about them. Because they're just doing it quietly, anonymously, right? They're not pretending to be shamans anymore. More power to them, absolutely. That's great. Again, don't look forward. Stay with the trip, the tripless trip. Even that's off track, right? Even that's off track. So you manage your misses. It's like golf. You manage your misses. Really, the spiritual path is very much like golf. You manage your misses. That's a little bit off track. Whoops, that's a little bit off track. Whoops. However wonderful the thinking may be, oh, this is profound. No, it's thinking about the future. It's thinking about what am I going to do in the future. Right away, that's not it. How am I going to function in the future? That's not it. That's not it, because we just swallowed the zero pill. And So people may say, oh, look at those spiritual people. They're really tripping out. Huh? They're really trippy people. They're weird. Well, they're on the tripless trip. The trip of not tripping out. The tripless trip. The trip that doesn't go anywhere. That's the intense trip. That's the wow that no shamanism can deal with, see? That's on beyond shamanism, absolutely. Doesn't really bear any resemblance to it. The others are all about trips. This is about the tripless trip. Different. You cannot join the two of them. You cannot serve two masters. Either you're taking a trip or you're not taking a trip. When you consciously take the tripless trip, this is boundless, eternally boundless. You're talking about eternally boundless. All is all. There's no boundaries, there's nothing to grasp. There's nothing to grab or grasp. There's not even an abyss there. You don't overcome the abyss. There isn't any abyss there. That's the tripless trip. The abyssless abyss. There is no abyss. There's nothing to fall into. So it's beyond the abyss. As this is being beyond the abyss. Because there isn't any abyss. There isn't any beyond. This is beyond the beyond. Because there isn't any beyond. This is not intellectual. I just say, holy cow, you know, it's like, wow, that's about it. That's great, great non-trip, a great tripless trip. Not going anywhere, there's nowhere to go. I'm already here, there is no here. The hereless here. There is no here and there is no there. It's like pouring gasoline on the fire. But again, are we going to let these Silicon Valley nerds outwork us? Really? They're in their cubicles coding right now. You think they take the weekends off? Maybe they do. Maybe we stole a march on them here, right? I don't take weekends off. I don't take any day off. I don't take the 4th of July off. To like over 6 hours of intense taping. I spent the rest of the day in contemplation. I don't take Saturday off. I don't take Sunday off. I don't take any day off. So they better work pretty hard to keep up. don't let your thoughts go to some other place, even if you think it's in this, not in the future, not in the past, some other parallel place. Don't even go parallel. Don't even go parallel. Just stay with the shock. Stay with the shock. Spiritual shock treatment. Stay with the shock. Don't go into memory. What did I say? Regurgitating what I said, the memory. So the different places, don't go parallel, don't go to the past, don't go to the future, don't go parallel, don't go memory. Memory is really the past. Where have I been? You know, what did I say? That's the past, isn't it? Yeah. But it feels a little different. Memory feels more immediate. Like you're thinking of imagining the past. Like, I wonder if some place in the past would be good. If, you know, some place that came before. Like going back to the 60s. What was that like? Whereas if we're thinking about going over what I just said, okay, now what did I just say? What did I just say? That's more me. It feels like memory, doesn't it? Rather than fantasy. Fantasy of the past. So it may be a separate category for that. You know, technically, I guess you could say it's the past. What did I say in the past? Where did I go in the past? Where was I in the past? Don't go parallel. Don't go past. Don't go past. Don't go parallel. Don't go future. With your presence, attention. Don't let your attention go to the past, parallel, or the future. Parallel means somebody else, somebody right now is over there, you know, the teachers, I think of them now, right now, I'm thinking of them right now. Now don't go into the parallel now. You know, don't go into the now, don't go into the past, don't go into the now, don't go into the future. But past, parallel, future. Just stay in the allness. Sort of the absence of past, present, and future. So there's not even a preference for the now in reality. There's no preference at all. So there's not a preference for what came before, there's not a preference for what is here now, and there's not a preference for what may come in the future. So it's neither past, present, or future. You know, the helpful teachers are all about practicing. They help you with your practice. They have advice, they have tips, you know, they say what's going to work for you. Find what works for you and use it. Everybody's a little bit different. They don't have like their practice. You got to do it. You know, they say, what's going to work for you? What's going to work right for you? But on the same hand, also, the no practice of stillness, as it were, needs to be there. It's not a polyglot. I mean, there have been some who say, here's thousands of practices. You know, potpourri, vast marketplace, some practices. No. Keep it very simple. Don't become one of these spiritual adventurers. That's a side trip too. That's a practice shaman. Don't be a practice shaman. I like that. That's an adventure shaman, actually. There's adventure shamans. They're great adventurers, you know. So they look at the spiritual path as an adventure. Adventure shaman. It's not an adventure. It's beyond that. The adventureless adventure is the tripless trip. So these adventurers, they adventure shamans, say, yeah, let's go to this retreat, let's go to that retreat, let's go, you know, spiritual trip, and as far as let's go, what do you call that? There's anyway, so like that, let's go here, let's go there, and let me arrange this, I'll go take this retreat and that retreat, let's try this technique. Yesterday I was trying this breathing technique, and today I look at this yoga technique I was using, I look at this book, there's so many techniques, I'm going to try this one, I'm going to try that one. Shamans, okay. Adventure shamans. Gotta go beyond that. So sitting quietly is the root base of it. Or sitting still is the base of it. And you can actually, for me, like I tape that, if that's helpful for me. You can have an MP3 recorder and you may sit very still and quietly and give a sort of running narration of what's going on, just to keep yourself right in the present, keep your thoughts from wandering off. It's sometimes very helpful to be speaking right now to keep the thoughts from going the past parallel or the present. That can be very helpful. Sit quietly, no action going on. Pay attention when you're physically active. I find it really dissipates the trip. You don't want to dissipate it. You want to take it, the tripless trip. When you get physically active, you're on a trip. You're back on your trip. Here is the tripless trip. We don't want to go back on a trip. Some use speech to simply stay on a trip. tripping on speech. So that's being on a trip. But you can also speak and help you stay with the trip. That is also possible. Now, is it possible for physical exercise or activity? That is possible too. You may be able to take a walk, or somehow you're able to feel in this almost like a stillness of non-walking or non-movement. That is possible. See, all this stuff's possible. But you don't want to be a spiritual adventure, you don't want to be a spiritual shaman, as it were, in that way. So there are many, I don't know how to use the words, because I guess a little, but many more of trying to be spiritual shamans in that way, which is not the way. So I say, for me, a reassure on the tripless trip, not a shaman, but a reassurer. So there's spiritual adventurers, spiritual shamans, all these different shamans who want to be experts. So I'm this expert, I can expertly do this. But even a spiritual shaman is not it. Trying to get the right technique. This is beyond that. Keep it as simple as possible, and then even simpler. Spiritual shaman will try to arrange the music, the exercise, the whole nine yards. That's a spiritual shaman. No, this is beyond that. It's not it. This is simply keeping your attention present, but not as an end in itself. The important, if you just keep your attention present and you're not, didn't swallow the zero pill, then you're just a spiritual shaman. A lot of spiritual shamans, mindfulness, will keep your mind on the present here. You think that's it? No. That's being a spiritual shaman. Keep your mind on your suffering. Keep your mind on this strain. Keep your mind. Easy. You can walk, take a walk, and keep saying, I'm being mindful. I see this nice house, nice yard. I'm in the now. I hear the birds singing. It's great. I feel more centered because I'm aware of all these various forms, and I'm paying attention to what's here now. Okay. But if you've just swallowed the zero pill, that's a totally different situation. You don't really care about that stuff. You don't care whether I'm mindful or not mindful or anything. What this and that, that tree, whatever. Forget it. I'm not focused on externals at all. Neither focused on externals nor internals. Nor obsessed about the now. Past, neither past, present, or future. Just with the wow. Just be with the wow. Like, am I okay? Am I still okay? I mean, what's going to happen to I? Don't know. Don't speculate. Just manage the fear, manage the trepidation. Just keep the faith, keep the trust, keep the faith, keep the trust. I'm just holding faith. Hold your faith. Hold your faith. Continuity of fear. I'm just letting the continuity fear evaporate. I'm just hanging out with the evaporation of the continuity fear is all I'm doing. I'm just hanging out with that. Okay, one moment here. All right, very great. I'm just hanging out here with the evaporation of the continuity fear. That's it. That's all I'm doing. Just hanging out. Just letting it evaporate. And that's it. That's it. Just do it. That's it. Very great. Just do it.